French criminal earned the name of the Man of a Thousand Faces, who taunted the cops for 20 years. He robbed dozens of banks, kidnapped and killed people. He even escaped the most secure prisons multiple times. This vicious criminal was known as the French Robin Hood, as well as the public enemy number one. He was clever in disguising and eluding capture. That's why in today's episode, we brought before you the true story of Jack Mesrine. Before we start, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell to turn on notifications. Jacques René Mesrine was born on 28 December 1936 in Clichy, Paris, in a social class family. As a child, he was extremely tenacious and was expelled from several schools because of his aggressive behaviors. At the age of 19, he fell in love with a woman named Lydia de Souza and married her. But the marriage didn't last long because the couple divorced a year later. Subsequently, Mesrine was enlisted in the French army and sent to the Algerian War. While in there, his duties were to torture and kill prisoners, the thing which would later change him into an obsessed murderer after leaving the army in 1959. But it wasn't until 1961 when he became involved with the secret organization army. During that time, he committed several robberies and was captured and sentenced to 18 months in prison for the first time. After Mesrine was released, his family bought him the tenancy of a country restaurant to quit his bad behaviors. But this didn't satisfy his needs because the lure of easy money and women proved impossible for him to resist. So that he returned to crime. In 1966, Mesrine moved to the Canary Islands, and at the same year, he robbed a jewelry store in Genova and a hotel in Chamonix. He also robbed a fashion store in Paris and committed other robberies, causing him to fled to Quebec with his mistress, Jean Schneider, in February 1968, and worked for a man named Georges Delaurier as a driver and housekeeper for a period of time. At that time, Mesrine had a problem with his employer, the thing which led him to think about kidnapping him with the help of his mistress. But fortunately, the scheme failed when a supposedly strong calmative had no effect on Delaurier, and the two fled to the United States on June 26, 1969. Simultaneously, an elderly woman was found dead, and on an information which included that the woman may have given a refugee to them. Mesrine and his mistress were captured on July 16 in Arkansas and extradited to Quebec, where they both incarcerated in the Percy prison. But after a few weeks, Mesrine escaped the prison for the first time and was arrested the next day and sentenced to 10 years for the botched kidnap attempt in the St. Vincent de Paul Penitentiary in Laval, the most secure prison in Canada. In 1971, his mistress was acquitted for the murder of the elderly woman in US, as well as him too. On August 21st, 1972, Mesrine escaped the prison through cutting the wires with five others, including Jean-Paul Mercier, a murderer. At that time, they both began robbing banks in Montreal for a period of time, and sometimes robbing two banks at the same day. Simultaneously, Mesrine and Mercier made an extremely risky attempt to break into a high security jail on September the 3rd. 1972, to release friends, but they only injured two policemen after the shootout. A week later, they were recognized by two forest guards, but they murdered them with no hesitation, the thing which led the Canadian authorities to increase the effort to arrest the two vicious criminals. However, at that time, Mesrine was still robbing banks in Montreal. He even disguised another face and successfully made it to the United States for a short period of time before moving to Caracas, Venezuela. Mesrine was clever in disguising. He was well known as the Man of a Thousand Faces, the thing that facilitated his travelings. Finally, in 1972, he returned to France under bewildering disguises and false names. Then he began a series of raids on banks as he did before, two banks at the same day, in the same territory, until he was arrested in March 1973. The mad genius Mesrine was eager to escape with an impossible plan, so that, during his trial, he took the judge as a hostage, using a gun which was hidden in the courtroom toilet. Then he escaped, leaving everybody shocked. With this escape, Mesrine was branded by the press as the French public enemy number one. After 4 months of the intense police patrol to arrest him, and based on an information provided by a former partner, he was finally busted in Paris in his apartment on September 28, 1973. He didn't resist or fight said officer Broussard. He knew he was under siege, so I gave him the choice to come out unarmed or die. He asked if I was Commissaire Broussard, with the beard, and would I approach unarmed, which I did. He then opened the door with the biggest cigar in his mouth, invited me, and offered me a glass of champagne. After that, he was sentenced to 20 years, and was sent to La Santé prison, a high secure prison. While behind bars, he wrote and smuggled out L'Instinct de Mort, autobiography, in which he said that he killed 39 people. While in the prison, he was incarcerated in a new wing built especially to hold him. However, a report noted that Misrine was exercising in his cell and was behaving like he received good news. On the 8th of May, 1978, under circumstances that had never been clear, Misrine escaped the prison with another inmate called François Bessé, and they became the first men to escape from La Santé prison. After the escape, the two robbed a gunsmith in Paris, and on May 26, 1978, they robbed a casino of 130,000 francs and wounded two customers, then fled before the police arrived. While police were looking for Misrine, he threatened to kidnap and murder the interior minister in an interview stating, "I will never surrender. Now it is war." Then he was featured on the cover of the August 4, 1978 Paris match. Furthermore, he tried to kidnap a judge who had sentenced him to prison, but he failed. Moreover, he kidnapped a millionaire and obtained an expensive ransom of 6 million francs. At that time, a journalist named Jacques Tillier accused Misrine of being dishonorable crook in a print. The thing that led Misrine to track him into a cave for a promising interview. Then he stripped, tortured him, and shot him 3 times. But fortunately, he survived. In October 1979, Commissaire Broussard received some information that Misrine was living with his new mistress, Sylvia Jean Jacot, near the port de Clignancourt, so that undercover patrols and detectives were combing the area and watching around the building for a few days, until the 2nd November 1979, when the couple were in a BMW car surrounded by 15 vehicles and 50 policemen, who opened fire and killed Misrine with 15 struck times, while his mistress lost one eye and suffered damage to her arm. After his death, French police received congratulations from the president, Valéry Giscard. The authorities would later find a tape in a drawer in his apartment addressed to his love, Sylvia Jean Jacot. "Hello, darling. If you read this, I'll have been killed by the police, which is nothing we didn't expect. I died with my gun in my hand, and even though I might not have time to use it, if I had, I would." This turned out to be true. He hadn't time to use his guns, which the police found in his car. Subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss more videos of crimes and mysteries and much more interesting stories. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.